Okay, well, this next video just cracks me up every time I see it. I still get, I mean, it's just hilarious. Robbie doing a parody of Rod Stewart. We used to do this live in our show across the country when we were touring, and I have so many great road stories because I don't know what it was about this one, but every time he did it, something crazy would happen. Like he'd trip, or he'd, one time he almost strangled himself with the scarf that was around his neck. And every time he did it, he blamed it on everybody else. It was always everybody else's fault that something happened, you know? Anyway, he'd go off stage. We used to do these fast costume changes where I would do Dolly Parton and then he would go off and change and come on and do Rod Stewart, and I would run off and change for Tina Turner, and he would come on and do Mick Jagger, and I don't know, we did Elton John, and there was a whole bunch of things going on. It was really fast and really crazy, so crazy things were bound to happen. But anyway, this was in a controlled environment on our TV show, Robbie doing a parody of Rod Stewart, and it still cracks me up to this day. Here we go.
Now, during our summer series last year, we had a very special guest on one of the shows, and the response was tremendous. I mean, Cheryl, you saw the fan mail, eh?
Well, I think your mom writes beautiful letters.
She's just joking. I mean, we went all out to get this guy back.
We called collect.
This guy is incredible. He's extraordinary. This fellow's dynamite.
Well, he's not. Dynamite.
But Cheryl, this guy's fantastic.
Well, that's what he says.
Let's let the people judge for themselves, okay?
Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, the man who proved that blondes do have more fun, Mr. Stewart Rodney.
Not dynamite.
Go forward. Woo!
His lips are dry, her heart's gently pounding. Don't you just know exactly what she's thinking? If you want my bug and you think I'm sis, come on sugar, let me know. If you feel you need me just because I'm sleazy, come on hon and tell me so. Looking for an answer. Come on, honey, let's spend the night together. Now hold on a minute before we go much further. Give me a dime so I can phone my mom. They catch a cab to his high-rise apartment. At last he can tell exactly what is happening. If you want my phone and you think I'm sick, come on, sugar, let me. I love you, honey!